Hillary Clinton has been sliding in the polls recently, with Bernie Sanders gaining on her and talk of other candidates potentially getting into the race. So if Hillary's been watching the news the last couple weeks, this is what she's heard.
Are Hillary Clinton supporters now in panic mode?
If you Google the words tonight, Hillary Clinton and panic, you'll have plenty of reading to do.
It's near panic for a lot of Democrats.
Is there some sort of panic mode setting in into the Hillary Clinton campaign?
Is that a world where there's such panic and there's such chaos that things crumble for Hillary Clinton?
Looks like Hillary has become the favorite candidate of the Demopanic Party. The Demopanic Party. In a recent NBC poll, just 39% of Americans said they viewed Hillary positively, compared it to 47% who viewed her negatively. So what's causing the slide? Well, two things. First, her use of a private email account while Secretary of State. Yesterday, the State Department released another 6,000 pages of Hillary's emails, and some of them are damning, not because they contain any evidence of wrongdoing, but because they make Hillary look incredibly uncool. Take, for example, this email in which Hillary says of a congresswoman who recently announced her retirement, quote, "I'd like to call her, but right now I'm fighting with the White House operator who doesn't believe I am who I say I am." That's either a White House operator who is bad at their job or someone playing an incredibly good prank.
You reach the White House? You say your name is Hillary Clinton? Prove it.
And then there's this email in which Hillary goes full parent on Facebook mode and asks an aide, "By the way, what does FUBAR mean?" To which the aide responds, "FUBAR is unprintable on civil email." So while we still don't know if Clinton ever emailed classified information, it's nice to know her staff knew never to email the words up beyond all recognition. So the emails haven't helped Hillary, but it's not the only thing that's been hurting her in the polls. Republicans have also been investigating Hillary's role in the aftermath of the 2012 Benghazi attack in what has now become the longest special congressional investigation in history, surpassing the 1970s Watergate investigation, as well as the 2000 investigation that failed to answer the question, who let the dogs out?
Now, maybe you can clear this up for me. You say when you went to bed, the door was locked. But Nora, please let me finish. But in the morning, you woke up and the dogs were just gone? My question to you is, who let the dogs out? Who? Who? Who?
Despite the lengthy Benghazi investigation, Republicans have yet to uncover any evidence of wrongdoing on Hillary's part, and most observers have suspected that the investigation is just an attempt to torpedo Hillary's standing in the polls. But it's not like any high-ranking Republicans, say House Republican Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy, would ever come out and admit to that.
Everybody thought Hillary Clinton was unbeatable, right? But we put together a Benghazi special committee, a select committee. What are her numbers today? Her numbers are dropping. Why? Because she's untrustable. But no one would have known any of that had happened had we not
thought
and made
something
that happen.
Good.
I don't think you were supposed to give away that was your plan. Haven't you seen a James Bond movie? The minute you start talking about the plan, he gets away. Now, many Republicans are criticizing McCarthy for his comments, which isn't good timing for him since he's angling to replace John Boehner as Speaker of the House. Now, what do we know about McCarthy? Well, according to an article in today's New York Times, Kevin McCarthy has built a loyal following among House Republicans by calling them up just to gab and giving them special jackets when they joined his vote-whipping team. I'm sorry, special jackets? I find it hard to believe you could win loyalty from members of Congress just by giving them free jackets. In fact, just read this quote from the same article by former Congressman Tim Griffin. "No one will outwork him. He comes to districts. He was accessible and available. Then there were little things, like jackets for our whip team." Those kind of details are not lost on members. Whip team jackets? Is this Congress or the Pink Ladies? Despite McCarthy's comments, Republicans have defended the Benghazi investigation, saying they're not a partisan attack on Hillary, but merely an attempt to get at the truth. Although, if that's true, how do you explain these comments from Democratic Congressman Adam Schiff?
They have not worked with Democrats at all. They've called witnesses without telling us. They've interviewed several witnesses. They didn't tell us they were going to interview them. They didn't invite us to participate.
So they've been holding meetings and just not inviting the Democrats. You can't ice people out because you think they're losers. This isn't high school. Oh, right, it is. They have special jackets. It's high school. Now back to Hillary. Whether it's the emails or Benghazi, she has been hurting in the polls, which has not only seen Bernie Sanders close in, but has also opened up the possibility of Joe Biden entering the race. The Biden talk got more serious this week when CNN announced that they would allow Joe Biden to participate in their Democratic debate on October 13th, even if he doesn't declare his candidacy until the day of the debate. And I, for one, am pulling for that for no other reason than I assume Joe Biden would enter a debate at the last minute the same way Kramer enters the door on Seinfeld. Worst of all, the Hillary panic has a side effect that isn't good for anyone. It's making Hillary try to show people she's fun. Here she is at a campaign stop last week, dancing with supporters and looking supernatural while she does it. Now that is FUBAR. But if it's true that Republicans created a political sideshow that has lasted a year and a half and cost millions of dollars just to hurt Hillary in the polls, that is even more FUBAR. This has been Dem-a-Panic Party. We'll be right back with more late night.